did you get here?
Earlier today. Wow, I hear congratulations are in order, huh?
Yes, yes, that's right. Imagine me, a Sadie.
Oh, please. Why, it would be such a shock that some lucky galoot would want to marry you, huh?
Brent, what are you doing here? I thought you went to see Jax.
I did. That's why I'm here. Can we talk for a minute? So, from what I overheard, I can only assume that Tracy is trying to get Jax to go in on some scheme to undermine ELQ.
Not to be rude, but my eyes were already starting to glaze over whenever the initials ELQ are mentioned. I'll be with the lasagna. No, don't worry.
So, obviously, I am not surprised that Tracy is up to no good, but I do not appreciate her recruiting my husband into this. And you know what? I'm not even going to do this right now. I won't.
What? You won't what?
No, I mean, I won't let myself get all upset and caught up in Jax's business. We all know I've done that before and where it got me, so... I just thought that maybe I should come over and tell you guys about this. Because you're my friends. And unfortunately for you, Tracy is your mother.
Well, thanks for the warning.
You're welcome. So, what's all this?
Well, haven't you heard? We're moving to L.A.
I know that, but I didn't think you were leaving right away. You're not going to leave and not say goodbye to me.
Oh, come on. Don't be silly. Oh, come on. I expect to see your glowing face the day my baby is born. Besides, she's going to need her godmother to help her father catch her.
Well, you know I'll be there.
Yeah.
And I wouldn't miss it for anything in the world. Mm-hmm. Oh, I've got to get out of here.
Hey, help me up. I'll walk out.
Okay. All right, so I'll call you later.
Okay. I hate this so much. I mean, Brenda's so happy with Jax, you know? I mean, how's she gonna feel when she finds out that he ain't no innocent lamb being led to the slaughter?
Well, if she cares about him enough, they'll work it out. We did.
Think so?
Well, ultimately, it's only business.
Hello?
Lois, hi, it's Jax. Listen, would Brenda be there by any chance?
You just missed her.
Oh, did she say she was on the way home?
Sorry.
Okay. Listen, say hi to Ned, okay?
Jax says hi. Can you believe that? Where you going?
Upstairs to get more boxes.
Oh.
Hey.
Hey. Thanks for meeting me.
Sure. No problem. What's up?
I need you to answer a question for me.
Sure, if I can.
You're gonna think this is about us, but it's not. It's about something that's really important to me, and I really need for you to be completely honest with me, if you can.
I'll give my best shot.
When we were involved, why was it so important that I couldn't know about your business? I mean, I know about the legal part. If I didn't know anything, then I couldn't hurt you if I was subpoenaed to testify.
That was part of it, yeah.
But if you were running a legitimate conglomerate, would you have felt the same way?
Probably.
Why?
I can only speak for myself.
You're the one I'm asking.
Okay. I thought it would be better if you weren't involved in the business. No part of it. If I kept it separate, then you wouldn't get hurt by the things that I have to do.
So you were protecting me?
Yeah, like I always told you. You know, I was also protecting myself because I didn't want to have to watch you struggle with the choices that I make.
Billy understood that.
She had a
an advantage. Her father was Rivera. She grew up in that life. I don't know if I've answered your question.
I think I understand. Finally.
Well, you know what they say.
Yeah, better late than never.
Yeah, that's right. Why do I get... I mean, I don't want to... But why do I get the feeling this has something to do with Jax?
Another time. Okay?
Sure. That's fine.
Thanks.
Safe to come in. Tracy's gone.
Good. I guess it shouldn't really matter to me who you have here on business.
Well, this is your home, too.
Right. But you know that she bothers me, and you know that she likes to cause trouble.
Well, if the trouble you suspect is that I'm trying to take Danny or Q...
Well, I don't want to accuse you of anything,
well,
but I...
you may as well. Because that's what I'm going to do. Shocked.
I am.
Oh, it's natural. Look, you know what I do? You know when I win, someone else has to lose. It just never happened before your eyes.
It's never happened to people that I know and people I care about.
Well, all the businesses, near and far, that have lost so I could succeed and offer you this charmed life of ours, they're no less deserving of sympathy because they never had you to dinner. I mean, that is, if sympathy were warranted.
Oh, wait a minute. I get this. This is about Tracy, right? Tracy came up with all this, and she came to you and tried to get you to get involved.
I wasn't unwilling, okay? I'd do the same thing tomorrow if I had to. But yes, Tracy came to me, like Lois came to me. People come to me all the time. Sometimes people I wouldn't have to dinner, like Tracy. But this is business. Look. I take a hard look. I study the company in question. If I find it's become lazy or degraded and isn't playing the game well anymore, then I know I can beat it. And I do.
The Quartermains don't think of this as a game, Jax.
Oh, no. To them, it's an entitlement. But life doesn't write anyone a blank check. Look, take L&B Records. As small as you are, I couldn't do you much damage because there's no foothold for me. You and Lois are still hungry. You love what you do. That keeps the operation supple. But ELQ, it's past its prime. It doesn't know why it exists anymore, except to keep the family in silk shirts, pay the maids to pick them up and wash them. Look, history's impatient with pointlessness. Look at Rome. Look at the Quartermains. They've lost their way. And callous. But what does it mean? Really mean to own something, huh? All those hundreds of acres with all those buildings on them. It means your name is on a bit of paper in a cabinet somewhere, that's all. The land doesn't give a damn. It'll be there long after you're gone. You get to say the buildings are yours. But all you can ever really occupy is the space between your shoes and your hat. Yes, it's a game. With referees we elect to keep track of the pieces of paper, and banks to keep score to tell us who's ahead. You take them away, how real is any of it? Look, the world owns us, not vice versa. It gives us life and feeds us. And then it feeds us to the worms, and that's ownership. I'm not sure about the others, but I'm sure Edward understands this. Maybe it takes climbing high enough to see over the top. Of course, he'll put up a fight, but I'm betting he's going to have the time of his life rebuilding everything from scratch. I know I will. Mm. When it's my turn. Of course, from scratch is a relative term. No one we know will starve. But people do. There are people sick who could be cured, but it won't be. People live in cardboard boxes. People who will never have enough to get by because the referees and the scorekeepers say so. They're the ones with everything at stake, not us. So if I get a little impatient at the thought of the Quatermain's tears, then that's why.
Are you going to have me thinking that this could be the best thing that could ever happen to them?
It's not important. It'll take care of itself. What matters to me is being the best thing that ever happened to you.
Well, you keep me guessing.
Well, it's just not my intention.
Oh, no, I know you don't do it on purpose. You know, I remember when I used to listen to people talk about you, like Edward and newspapers, and they used to all talk about how ruthless you are. And I used to think that you totally had them snowed. But you are.
Yeah, but not in real life.
Oh.
What? Do you want some guy who's a washout at work and a throws his weight around at home?
Oh, you think those are my choices?
Yeah.
Listen, this better be a friendly takeover.
Well, for what it's worth, Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde are both crazy in love with you.
Do you know I've never been with someone who doesn't hold anything back?
But I did.
Until I asked you. I think I'm going to be careful about what I ask you about from now on, because you'll just tell me.
I want to give you everything you've never had before. And I can, if you let me.